Welcome to session 9 of second module, where we are going to discuss about oscillators. So now let us first take the basic structure before discussing an FET oscillator. So the basic structure of an amplifier is oscillator is as shown. So an oscillator is a type of feedback amplifier, so in which a part of the output signal is fed back to the input using a feedback circuit, okay, or you can say part of the output is fed back to the input through a feedback circuit. Okay, so in this basic structure, here we are going to represent X naught as the output, XF as the feedback signal, and XI as the input. Okay, so later stages we will take this XI is equal to 0. But still, for the analysis purpose, let us take XI as the input for the further discussion. So now here, in the first block, the gain of the amplifier is indicated by capital A, and the frequency selective network, okay, so that is the fraction of output which is fed back, okay, that is indicated by XF, and the amount by which it is fed back is indicated by the feedback factor beta. Okay, so here the input voltage is of course 0 in this circuit. So, and also the feedback is a positive feedback, and finally the closed loop gain of the amplifier will be denoted by capital A in this case. Okay, so therefore let us derive some conditions or the relations in this basic structure. So from the block diagram, okay, so we can write some important conditions. So let me indicate here as a VD, that is a difference voltage. Okay, so here VD is nothing but the XF, that is the fed back signal, plus XI. So this is because of the positive feedback, and also output signal X naught is nothing but gain into VD, because VD is the signal which is passing through this amplifier block. So therefore X naught will be obviously equal to A into VD, and also the feedback signal XF is equal to beta into X naught, because beta times of X naught will be fed back. Okay, so now using these three relations, so now let us try to derive the transfer function, that is X naught by XI. So I will substitute in this. X naught is equal to A into VD, but VD is XF plus XI. XF plus XI. So this is equal to A into XF plus A into XI. So again, substituting for XF, so X naught will be equal to A into XF is beta into X naught. So beta into X naught plus A into XI. Therefore, grouping the terms, it is possible to write that X naught by XI will be equal to A divided by 1 minus A beta. A divided by 1 minus A beta. Okay, so this is an important relation showing the relation between X naught and XI, along with the amplifier gain A as well as the feedback factor beta. Okay, so now as X in is equal to 0, so X in is equal to 0, and also X naught is not equal to 0. So this is what is the condition. So this implies that obviously A into beta should be equal to 1. A beta is equal to 1. Okay, so therefore now this equation, okay, so it indicates two requirements for the oscillator. So this is also equal to 1 into 0 degree or 360 degree in the polar form. Okay, so this expression gives the two requirements. That is, first one is the magnitude of the loop gain A beta must be at least equal to 1, and the second requirement is the total phase shift of the loop gain, that is A into beta, must be either equal to 0 or 360 degrees. So these are the necessary conditions for a oscillator, and also the feedback circuit must provide an additional phase shift of 180 degree. Because already 180 degree phase shift is provided by the amplifier. So the feedback network will provide again additional 180 degree phase shift, so that the total phase shift around the loop will be equal to 360 degrees. Okay. So therefore, with this basic information, so let us look into an FET based phase shift oscillator as per the syllabus. So here the circuit diagram is as shown. Here the oscillator circuit is built with the field effect transistor, and it is RC phase shift oscillator. So there are three RC networks, and for the further analysis we may have to write an equivalent circuit also. Okay. Just looking at the circuit diagram of FET based phase shift oscillator, it consists of an amplifier in which the active element is the FET, and it consists of the feedback network, and the feedback network consists of three cascaded RC sections. Okay. And also, as shown in the circuit, the feedback voltage here VF, it is indicated by VF, and it is taken at the last RC stage. So, and it is fed back as the input to the gate terminal as an input. And now here 180 degree phase shift is given by the amplifier itself. So therefore, the RC network will provide another 180 degree phase shift, making it totally 360 degrees around the loop. And here every RC section, or each RC section, is designed to give a phase shift of 60 degrees at the desired frequency of oscillations. Okay. Now, in order to calculate further loop gain, we need to write equivalent circuit diagram, and the equivalent circuit, or you can also call it a simplified small signal AC equivalent circuit for the FET amplifier, is as shown in this figure. Okay. So here we can just see that the resistors RD and capital RD are connected in parallel with the current source GM into VI. And of course, V naught is taken at the end of the RD here, and there will be three stages, and after the third stage, the VF, that is feedback voltage VF, is taken. Okay. And here, for further simplification, the parallel combination between small RD and the capital RD. Okay. So the parallel combination equivalent resistance is considered, that is RD dash. So therefore, to proceed with further derivation, the small signal equivalent circuit shown in the previous diagram is still more simplified by replacing this current source with a parallel resistance by a voltage source with a series resistance RD dash. Okay, so just look at the previous circuit diagram. Here we have a current source, okay, and parallel resistor RD dash. So now it is replaced by a voltage source GM RD dash VI, which is in series with the resistor RD dash. So remaining RC networks are as it is, and we have marked VF and all. And also, now as we have to calculate here how much is the VF, okay, feedback voltage. Okay, so we need to consider individual loop currents also. So therefore, so as the equivalent circuit forms three loops, there are three loop currents I1, I2, I3. Okay, so therefore, now with this we are going to write what is the feedback voltage expression. Okay, so here the feedback voltage VF is given by I3 into R. Okay. So therefore, in order to find VF, we need to compute what is this I3. Okay. So therefore, as it is a loop current, the only way of finding I3 is we need to first write three loop equations, and we are going to get three equations, as three unknowns are there. So we can use Cramer's rule after writing the linear equations in the form of matrix, and with the help of Cramer's rule, it's possible to find all I1, I2, I3. But as we know, as we want to know only I3 value, so just we will compute only the I3. Okay. So therefore, first we will write the loop equations. Therefore, for the first loop, the equation will be I1 into, see this, the I1 current, that is in the first loop, the resistance R is there, common resistance between two loops. So therefore, R into I1 minus I2 we can represent, plus there is I1 into 1 by SC capacitor. So and this is what, minus I2 into R. Why it is? Because R into I1 minus I2, and that is equivalent to I1 into R minus I2 into R plus I1 1 by SC. So this is equal to minus GM RD dash into VI. RD dash into VI. This is for the first loop. In the second loop, similarly, R into I2 minus I1 plus I2 into 1 by SC plus R into I2 minus I3 equal to 0. This is for the second equation. Okay. So similarly, we can write for the third equation. In the third loop, R into I3 minus I2 plus 1 by SC into I3 plus R into I3 equal to 0. So these are for the three loops. Okay. So we can write simplified equations. So by just rearranging the terms, now it is possible to arrange them in the matrix form, that is R plus 1 by SC minus I2 into R, that will be equal to minus GM RD dash into VI, call it as equation 1. Similarly, minus I1 into R plus I2 into 2R plus 1 by SC minus I3 into R equal to 0. This is for the second loop. And for the third loop, I2 into R plus I3 into 2R plus 1 by SC equal to 0. Third equation. Okay. So therefore, in the matrix form, we will arrange R plus 1 by SC into minus R, because as I3 is 0 in the first equation, so we'll put this as 0. Similarly, minus R in the second equation, we have all I1, I2, I3 coefficients, so therefore 2R plus 1 by SC and minus R. So I1 is 0 in the third equation, so remaining I2 and I3 terms are there, 2R plus 1 by SC. Okay, so this will be multiplied with I1, I2, I3, that will be equal to minus GM RD dash VI 0, 0. So this is the matrix representation. Okay. So now from this, now it is possible to find what is I3 using Cramer's rule. Using Cramer's rule, I3 can be written as I3 is equal to delta 3 divided by delta 3 by delta. So delta is nothing but determinant of the matrix, that is where delta is equal to determinant of -r 0 -r 2r plus 1 by sc -r 0 -r 2r plus 1 by sc. okay, so it is verified that the determinant that we are going to get is -1 minus 5 1 by omega C r whole square plus j into 1 by omega R C cube minus 6 into 1 by omega R C. okay, to get it in the simplified form, it is assumed that let alpha is equal to 1 by omega RC, alpha is equal to omega RC. By substituting this, delta is equal to 1 minus 5 alpha square plus j into alpha cube minus 6 alpha. So this is the delta value. Okay, so next we need delta 3 also. So therefore, to write delta 3, we have to replace the third column by minus gm rd dash vi. Okay, so we have to rewrite like this. First column remains as it is, minus r 0 minus r. Second column also as it is, 2r plus 1 by sc minus r. But in the third column we have to write minus gm rd dash vi 0 0. Okay, so the delta 3 value on simplification is given by minus gm rd dash vi into r square. Okay, so this is what is the delta 3 value. So now once delta and delta 3 are available, now it is possible to write I3. So I3 will be equal to delta 3 by delta. So this will be equal to minus gm rd dash vi r square whole divided by 1 minus 5 alpha square plus j alpha cube minus 6 alpha. Okay, and so here you need to substitute in place of delta. This r cube is there, which was taken as a common factor. Into R cube. Okay, so therefore, once we define how much is I3, now we'll go back to our VF equation. Okay, so we know that VF is given by I3 into R. Substituting I3 value, so minus gm rd dash vi to r cube. Okay, because one more r is there in the numerator, which will get multiplied with the numerator of the I3. So finally we are going to get into r cube, and here 1 minus 5 alpha square plus j into alpha cube minus 6 alpha r cube. So further, the r cube term gets cancelled. So now we can take out this vi term, as a Vf by Vi ratio giving minus gm rd dash minus gm rd dash divided by 1 minus 5 alpha square plus j alpha cube minus 6 alpha minus 6 alpha. Okay, but Vf by Vi is also equal to a into beta. Okay, therefore considering only the real part of delta, as loop gain is a real quantity, a beta is equal to minus gm rd dash by 1 minus 5 alpha square, because only the real part in the denominator is considered and the imaginary part is equated to 0. Okay, so therefore by equating alpha cube minus 6 alpha equal to 0, okay, we are going to get alpha square is equal to 6. Alpha square is equal to 6. Okay, and also we know that alpha is 1 by omega rc. Okay, so therefore omega square r square c square will become equal to 1 by 6, or this omega rc will be equal to 1 by root 6. Okay, so here itself we can calculate what is the frequency of oscillation. So the frequency of oscillation will be omega is equal to 1 by rc into root 6, or omega is nothing but what, 2 pi f naught, that is equal to 1 by rc root 6, or frequency of oscillation f naught will be equal to 1 by 2 pi rc into root 6. So this is our next equation 5, can call it as. Okay, so therefore now let us calculate the loop gain also. So therefore magnitude of a beta is equal to simply gm into rd dash by 1 minus 5 alpha square. We have, in place of alpha square, we'll substitute omega square r square and c square. Okay, so this is equal to gm into rd dash by 1 minus 5, its value will be 6. Omega square r square value will be equal to 6. Okay, so this is the reason is omega square r square c square is equal to 1 by 6. So that's why this ratio is now replaced by 6. So magnitude of a beta will be equal to now gm rd dash by 1 minus 30, magnitude is 29. It is 29. So this is our one of the important equation, Porter's equation 6. Okay, so therefore this is going to give the magnitude of the loop gain. This is the loop gain. Similarly, this is frequency of oscillation. Okay. So therefore, the condition here is magnitude of AB should be greater than 1 for sustained oscillation. Okay, so for sustained oscillations, therefore that gm into rd dash is greater than 29. Take it as equation 9. So the voltage gain of the FET amplifier is now given as voltage gain ABA greater than RD dash, or a is greater than 29, and hence beta will be equal to 1 by 29, equation 8. Okay, so therefore from these equations, the gain of the FET amplifier should be at least 29 in order to get the sustained oscillations. Okay, and also we have seen when the oscillations are generated, the frequency of those oscillations is given by F0 equal to 1 by 2 pi RC into root 6. Okay, so this is what different relations with respect to FET phase shift oscillator. So in order to arrive at these relations, what all steps we have followed is, we have taken the equivalent AC equivalent circuit of the FET amplifier, and here we have modified that current source is converted into a voltage source, and also the RD dash is neglected in these equations. As you can see, it is because the value of resistor R is very much greater than RD dash. So with these considerations, the three loop equations are written, and finally using the matrix simplifications, we could find what is I3, and using I3 we have defined how much is our feedback voltage VF. So VF equal to I3 into R. So substituting the I3 expression, we are able to generate the loop gain expression, that is AB equal to minus GM RD dash 1 minus phi alpha square. So finally, with these equivalents, it is calculated that the AB should be equal to more than 29 for the oscillations to generate. And finally, using these equations, we have determined what is the frequency of oscillations, that is F0 1 by 2 pi RC root 6. So with this, we conclude the discussion about FET oscillator. Thank you.